So today's lecture is about another poem by the famous and major Victorian poet Alfred Lord Tennyson. It is entitled Ulysses, and actually it is not a strange name for us as literature students. We are familiar with this name, Ulysses. It is the famous figure from the Greek mythology, the Odyssey by Homer, the Iliad and the Odyssey by Homer. Actually, Ulysses is the name of Odysseus, it's the Latinized name of Odysseus. And actually, Tennyson, I don't think we need to speak much about Tennyson because we already know that he represents this period, the Victorian period. The cultural values, the kind of ideas, the kind of problems, the issues that were spoken about in poetry of this period actually are reflected very well in the poetry of Tennyson. So it is always important to study poems by him. Ulysses is actually a very well-known figure in literature because actually the name itself or the figure also, the figure of Ulysses is used in many other literary works. We already know, for example, the novel by James Joyce, Ulysses. We also know that he was mentioned in Dante's Inferno. See the character of Ulysses. So it is popular and it is known, and many times it is used for the kind of meanings that it reflects. So before we start with this poem, what do you need to know about it first? The poem is a dramatic monologue spoken by the Greek hero Ulysses. So it is important to think about this dramatic monologue. It means that we have just this one speaker who's speaking alone by himself. It is not a dialogue, for example, between him and another person. He's talking, he's revealing things about himself maybe, or revealing his own thoughts or the ideas about something. And here the speaker is Ulysses himself. The time in which it was written in 1833, which marks an early period of the Victorian era. It was written in 1833 and I think it was published in 1842. So it is in the beginnings, the early time of the Victorian period. It reflects so many of what has started to become the major way of thinking, the major, let's say, ideas that dominated in this period. And we need also to think about the time in which Tennyson wrote this poem. It was after the death of his friend. So we can see that Tennyson actually is really affected by this incident in his life, the death of his closest friend. It is reflected in so many poems that are written by him, the idea of death, the idea of living, how to make use of life in the fullest form. So we see that this idea has actually engaged his mind so much, and it is reflected in so many poems, and one of them is this one, Ulysses. And as I told you, Ulysses is the Latinized form of the Greek mythical figure Odysseus, the ruler of Ithaca, who's first mentioned in the Iliad and the Odyssey, two of Homer's most famous works. So it is actually a very well-known figure from the Greek mythology. And in these works, we are told that after the Trojan War, he struggled to go back to his country, to go back home, you see? So what we are going to see in this poem, that Ulysses, the speaker, is speaking in old age. He's now old, okay? He's not talking from the time in which he was still in the prime youth. He was young, he was strong, he was powerful. Now he's talking as an old person, okay? What's the point you are going to see here in the poem? It little profits that an idle king by this still hearth among these barren crags matched with an aged wife, I met and dole unequal laws into a savage race that hoard and sleep and feed and know not me. I cannot rest from trouble. Notice here from the very beginning he's calling himself an idle king. What does it mean, idle king? يعني الملك العاطل, يعني كأنما هو عاطل عن العمل. You see, because he's old now, what is he doing? just a ruler who's governing this country. You see, and what is this life like? He's sitting by the hearth, the fireplace. Yeah, he's just sitting calmly there, among these barren crags. This place, which seems to be, you see, barren, uncivilized, you see. And what is he doing? Notice here, it says Ulysses is frustrated. This shows actually from the very beginning, the tone is the tone of frustration. إحباط يعني هذا الملك البطل اللي كان هو قبل محارب بطل عوليس الآن هو شنو؟ ملك عاطل جالس يعني حياته عبارة عن شيء مليء بالملل ما بي معنى ما بي من نفس ما كان قبل يعني كان بطل وكان محارب. See now he feels that his life is pointless as an old king. There is nothing in his life that is worth or that is interesting just like before. And notice how he described his wife, an aged wife. And of course, يعني he's aging. Of course, his wife is going to age with him. But he feels that, what kind of life is this? Living with an aged wife, having this boring life, doing nothing interesting. What is this? You see, he's trapped. He feels trapped in a life where he lives with an aged wife and a group of uncivilized people, even the people he's ruling. لاحظوا شلون يوصفهم. يقول يعني أنا كل عملي هسه شنو جدا أسوي؟ أصدر قرارات وأحكم مجموعة من الناس شبيهم savage race. Notice this one savage, uncivilized. What am I doing? That horde, شو شلون يوصفهم horde القطيع يسميهم القطيع. What do? They sleep, feed, and no, not me. They don't know what kind of ruler, what kind of person I am. Okay, I'm not the one to be ruling such people. لاحظوني يعني شو عدة تكبر على الناس حتى الناس اللي هو حاكم عليهم شايف نفسه عليهم. They only know how to eat, store wealth, sleep. Oh, you see, do all these usual things. They are ignorant of how Ulysses spent his life, and what did he do in his life? He was traveling. Adventuring. هو قضى حياته كلها يحارب وينتقل من مكان لمكان ومغامرات وكذا. هاي الحياة هم ما يعرفوها. هم شنو طبيعة حياتهم؟ يأكلوا يشربوا ينام. See? They are savage, uncivilized. I will drink life to the lees. لاحظوا هاي العبارة. I will drink life to the lees. This is what they don't know about me. I'm not that person who leads such life. What am I doing is that even though I am old now, but I will live my life to the fullest. صح أنا كبير بالعمر بس أنا أريد أعيش حياتي إلى أقصى حد. Okay, هذا التعبير هذا معناه. I will drink life to the lees. هاي to the lees هي شنو الفكرة مالتها؟ lees إذا دورون معناها هي شنو هذا ما يتبقى. هم عندهم كان قبل هاي براميل الخمر اكو هيك شيء يبقى فد شيء يعني بقعر هذا البرميل شعب البرميل مثل ما نقول بالعراقي. فهذا هذا ما ينترك يعني هذول اللي يشربون مثلا يشربون من هذا البرميل يقول لك انا اشربه كله ما ابقي شيء يعني حتى اوصل للنهايه. هو يقول انا اريد اشرب الحياه بنفس هاي الطريقه. I'm going to live life to the fullest, to the last moment. I'm not leaving anything. Okay? All times I have enjoyed greatly, have suffered greatly, both with those that loved me and alone, on shore and when through scudding drifts the rainy Hyades vexed the dim sea. What kind of life did he lead? What kind of life? Notice this. He enjoyed everything when he was happy and when he is suffering, all these kind of things, يعني he passed through, he lived them fully. Even when he was, for example, with other people, even when he's alone. يعني كل أحوال الحياة اللي ممكن يمر بها الإنسان هو مر بها، بس هو مر بها هو يعني سعيد إنه هو عاش بهاي الطريقة. You see, he found joy and fulfillment. يعني يحس نفسه حقق نفسه in all the times of his life, whether they are times of happiness, suffering, being with his crew members, with other people, being alone. لاحظوا من يقول هنا and alone. On shore, whether he's, for example, not in, on the sea. يعني مرات هو مثلا مو داي بحر بالبحر، قد يكون على اليابسة. كل أوقات هو يحس، كان يحس نفسه إنه هو شنو، هو داي يحقق شيء بالحياة. See, he enjoyed them all. On land, through the rainstorms, even the time that in times on sea that are considered to be difficult and dangerous times. Okay, he this high. طبعا هاي كلها references، طبعا allusions. He this هاي مجموعة من النجوم، constellation of stars. I think on the أعتقد كوكبة الثور يمكن، تورس. Sorry. It is believed that they bring rain. يعني whenever they appear, they bring rain with them. You see, so this is what he means. I am become a name for always roaming with a hungry heart. I'm famous for this. I'm famous for traveling all the time, for having this desire to explore things, to go around, to adventure. I'm sure بهذا الشيء، معروف عني. See, I'm famous for being an ardent explorer. Much have I seen and known, cities of men and manners, climates, councils, governments. يعني هاي رحلاته كلها شنو شافوه. He has seen everything. He has seen people. He has seen countries. He has seen different climates. He has known things about people and places. He has acquired knowledge. هاي كلها شو يقصد بيها؟ يقصد إنه أنا اكتسبت معرفة من تجوالي، من سفري. Okay. He has seen and known so much about people and places. He was honored whenever he goes. People know him. They honor him. They welcome him. See, myself not least, but honored of them all. Okay, and drank delight of battle with my peers, even when I was fighting in war. See, هو شخصيته معروفة كمحارب في حرب طروادة. حتى من كنت حارب، حتى من كنت محارب وقاتل وأقراني وجنود الوياي. Even that was one of the greatest times in my life. See, far on the ringing plains of windy Troy. يعني كنت حارب بطروادة ديك البلاد البعيدة. See, even that was a source of delight for him. He was delighted to fight alongside his soldiers back there in Troy. Okay, in the Troy حرب طروادة الشهيرة. I am part of all that I have met. So what does this create of me? It creates what person I am. This is who I am. يعني هاي يقول هاي أني خلاصة هاي التجارب. أني مجموعة هاي التجارب. See, I am part of all that I have met. I have taken something from everything. So his experience is part of who he is. Yet all experience is an arch weathered through, gleams that untraveled world whose margin fades forever and forever when I move. Here it seems that Ulysses, what he's doing, he's trying to say that there is a connection between my movement around, my traveling, and the experiences of this world. يعني يقول هذا العالم كأنما متوقف على تجربتي إله. سي يعني اكو بعض الفلاسفة شي يقولون انه تجارب الانسان بالحياة هي بمقدار وعيه لهاي التجارب. يعني انت هسه مثلا مجرد ما هاي التجارب او الافكار تطلع من وعيك، يعني خلاص كأنها ما موجودة بعد. سي بس تدخل في وعيك تحس بيها وتجربها، تعتبر بالنسبة لك هي موجودة. أوكي، فهذا الشيء ممكن هنا يكون مشابه. Notice here, for him, the unexplored world is experienced only when he is moving. يعني أنا من أتحرك أجرب وأشوف العالم، هذا العالم يدخل في وعي وبالتالي هو موجود، هذا العالم غير مكتشف لأني رايح أكتشفه. It is moving forward and exploring that makes Ulysses life. This is what makes life. هذا هو الحياة هيك تكون، لازم يعني بالحركة بالتجربة. أما أي شيء عدا هذا هاي ما تعتبر حياة. You are just sitting around. What are you doing? Eating, sleeping, so what? Where is life? What are you doing? You see? How dull it is to pose. شوف العبارة. How dull it is to pose, to make an end. تخيل أنت حياة هيك، زي أنت إذا توقفت. Dull. This is dull. To rust. يعني شنو rust؟ يصدأ. To rust unburnished. غير مصقول. صير كأنك هيك يعني مصدي. غير مثل شنو؟ يعني هنا طبعا هذا تشبيه. Not to shine in use. هذا السيف، يعني هذا طبعا هنا الإشارة إلى السيف. This is an, a reference, a metaphor of what? Of a sword, just like a sword. Imagine this sword which is designed to be fought with, to be used in war. It is left, for example, unused. What happens to it? It rusts. It is not burnished. It is not shining as when it is used to fight in the battle. يعني هذا السيف مصمم حتى يقاتل، انت من تخليه على صفحة شي يصير بي يصدق يخرب تروح لمعته. Okay, this is what happens to man as well. What life it is when one is stopping at one place rusting like a sword that is left unused instead of shining in the battle. Okay, this is a very beautiful image here. As though to breathe were life. Life piled on life were all too little, and of one to me little remains. يعني يقول هي شنو الحياة بس واحد عايش يتنفس. Being alive and breathing only is not what living truly is. See, هاي هنا هاي العبارة تفسر هذا المعنى هنا. It's not life just to breathe and live that just like that. وش يقول هنا وراه؟ Life piled on life. يقول لو تنطيني حياة بخوك حياة بعد ما تكفي. Okay, it's not enough. We're all too little. يعني قليلة ما تكفي. Not enough. And of one to me little remains. And this one life that I have now, there's just little. باقي منها شوي. وأنا هاي الحياة الوحدة اللي عندي هسه باقي منها شوي. Little remains. But every hour is saved from that eternal silence. Something more. A bringer of new things. Even if it is just one hour that is left. Every hour that is given to us before death. يعني كل ساعة كل لحظة أنت باقي عندك قبل تموت. لاحظوا هنا شنو eternal silence. الصمت الأبدي. الموت. Death. هاي معناها يعني هذا metaphor. This is a metaphor for death. ويقول كل ساعة هي شنو. Every hour is saved. It is something more. You can do something. You can add something to your life. A bringer of new things. There are new things to experience. ما دام اكو حياة بعد الموت ما جاي، إذن كل ساعة هي فرصة لشيء جديد. Okay. And violet were for some three suns to store and hoard myself. Okay. And it is, لاحظوا هاي كلمة vile هنا يقصد بها it is disgraceful. يعني هذا شيء معيب. To spend, sorry هنا هاي المفروض دي وليس تي. To spend the last years of his life eating and trying to stay alive. يعني بس هاي الحياة اللي هي مجرد يلا نمشي حال نعيش. يقول هاي معيب معيب على الإنسان هيك يعيش. For him, at least for him. Or for Ulysses. Okay. يعني even as an old man, notice here, and this grey spirit yearning in desire. Grey spirit. طيب ليش يقول grey spirit؟ باعتبار هو يعني الإنسان يكبر يصير شعره شايب العفو. فهو يعني حتى هيقول even this old age that I am in now doesn't prevent me, doesn't stop me from seeking new things, okay, to follow knowledge like a sinking star beyond the utmost bound of human thought. See the shooting stars, يعني هاي النجمة المذنب منين ينطلق هذا النجم، وين يروح؟ هيك تحسه كأنه ما منطلق، رايح البعيد. I'm just like this star، أنا مثل هاي النجمة، أريد أنطلق أروح. To seek knowledge just like this star, nothing stops me. Even if I am old, I still have this desire. Okay. This is my son. لاحظوا هسه هو كأنه ما دا يسولف إنه بعدين وصل إلى أن يحكي عن ابنه. منو ابنه؟ أكيد his son. Of course, he's the one who's going to be the king after his father. You see, he's the crown prince, something like this. This is my son, mine own Telemachus, to whom I leave the scepter and the isle. يعني after I die, who's going to be the king? Of course, my son. I'm leaving him with this responsibility. Well loved of me, discerning to fulfill this labor. He's well loved. He's good. He's a good person. My son is good. By slow prudence, but unlike his father, notice the character of the son. What is it like? Slow prudence. يعني عنده هاي الحصافة والهدوء والحكمة. To make mild a rugged people, still calling the people as what? Uncivilized, savage people. يقول يعني ابنه هو عنده هاي القدرة على انه هو يعني يروض هذول الناس. And through soft degrees, لاحظوا التعابير اللي يستخدمها من يوصف ابنه. Slow prudence, soft degrees, subdue them to the useful and the good. I'm sure my son is going to do this in a very good way because he has these characteristics. You see, he believes Telemachus will be a good ruler, will improve his subjects, and will properly honor his household gods when he is gone. لاحظوا هاي كلها تقريبا هاي من هنا، كل هذا كلام وصف لي انه ابنه شلون راح يجي من بعده. Most blameless is he, centered in the sphere of common duties. Common duties. لاحظوا شلون يوصف هاي المسؤولية الحكم. Common duties. هاي يعني الواجبات المعروفة المعتادة. Okay. Decent. Not to fail in offices of tenderness. طبعا هو هنا هاي الصفات كلها ينطيها لابنه. See all these characteristics that he's saying about his son. They seem the very opposite of his own characteristics. You see, he's not like this. He's the total opposite of his son. Okay. أكو نوع من الأنانية هنا بالوصف. He's like, you see, he seems to be selfish, or there's this kind of ego. Okay. You are a king. You must be actually knowing your responsibilities. But for him, it's not like this. Maybe his son is more suitable. Not me. I have another things to follow. Okay. هو طبعا لاحظوا هنا هو يقول he works his work, I mine. أنا شغلتي أروح أسافر وأسوي مغامرات وما أعرف شو، ابني هو يصلح لهذا العمل. You see, there lies the port, the vessel puffs her sail. يعني هو منا حكينا عن ابنه، هسه بعدين قام يأشر كأنه ما يأشر لنا، يقول شوفوا ها هنا هنا أنا هنا مكاني. The port, look at this port, look at this the ships. See it's sailing. There gloom the dark broad seas. Look at the seas, they are waiting for me. Okay, my mariners, رجالي ذول البحارة, souls that have toiled and wrought and thought with me, that ever with a frolic will come took the thunder and the sunshine, and oppose free hearts, free foreheads. You and I are old. Even though the my partners, يعني دول كلهم كانوا وياهم أكيد كلهم سكبار يعني old, they are old. You see, and they have troubled with me. They have experienced all these things with me. They know very well what lies ahead, what kind of things are there in the seas. They know these things. But I'm calling them, come with me. See? يعني بعد عندهم يعني هم ممكن يرافقوني حتى شنو in order to accomplish new things. Okay? Old age hath yet his honor and his toil. Okay? Death closes all. And he actually knows very well this truth that old age, okay, is followed by death. يعني الموت هو آخر شيء يعني النهاية. He knows this, but something near the end. But even though we know that death is coming, we shouldn't stop living. But what kind of life? A life that is filled with let's say with work, with adventures, with knowledge, with new experiences. This kind of life. So near the end, قبل النهاية يقول some work of noble note. Still we are able to accomplish something. May yet be done. Not unbecoming men that strove with gods. Okay, the lights begin to twinkle from the rocks. Everything is calling to go through some new experience. The long day wanes. Now, يعني سوى يحكي كأنما وصلنا هسه نهاية اليوم. You see, the long day wanes. The slow moon climbs. The deep moans round with many voices. The deep هنا يقصد بيه طبعا المحيط البحر يعني. يعني تجي منه أصوات. Come my friends. Come my friends. It is not too late. لاحظوا لحد هسه هو يفكر. ماكو وقت متأخر. والله أنا كبرت. والله أنا هسه كبير بالعمر بعد شنو مو مال أسوي تجارب بعد ما عندي تجارب ما عندي ماكو شيء أعيش له ماكو شيء أجربه بعد خلص. No, it's not too late to seek a newer world. Push off and sitting well in order smite the sounding furrows for my purpose holds to sail beyond the sunset and the paths of all the western stars until I die. Until I die. إلى أن أموت. أنا عندي استعداد أطلع أروح أغوص بهذا العالم أشوف وأجرب وأعيش هاي الحياة. See, they may be old. Actually, he and his man, they may be old. Death may be around the corner, but before they succumb, there will be one last voyage beyond the sunset and no return. إلى أن أموت أنا رح أظل أعيش هاي الحياة. It may be that the gulls will wash us down. Okay? As the day, هنا طبعا هنا المقطع السابق ويا هذا. They may drown or perhaps find the happy isles. Happy isles, it may be we shall touch the happy isles. يعني happy isles هاي بالميثولوجيا الإغريقية. مثل الجنة يعني. Heavens. The place where the blessed souls go to, the happy isles. This is in Greek mythology. So maybe we die, maybe we go to the heavens, who knows? And see the great Achilles. هو يعني باعتبار Achilles بالميثولوجيا الإغريقية كان يعني he's a blessed soul. يعني هو بالنعيم كان يعني بالجنة. أخيل تعرفون قصة أخيل اللي أخيل هو كان يقاتل وياه طبعا نفس الحرب تروجن وور. اللي انضرب في كاحلة يعني whom we knew. Okay, though much is taken much abides and though we are not now that strength which in old days. احنا مو مثل قبل صحيح. We are not as strong as we used to. Okay, but still you see هنا يقول though they are not as strong as they used to be they are still heroic. لاحظوا يقول one equal temper of heroic hearts made weak by time and fate but strong in will to strive. صح الوقت خلانا نكبر بالعمر. See, to made us what? Made weak by time and fate but still what about the will, الإرادة شبيها strong to strive to seek to find and not to yield. يعني هذا القلب عنده إرادة قوية إنه شنو يكافح يسعى ويجد الأشياء، يبحث عن أشياء ولا يستسلم. You see? Okay. What is it like about, let's say here, what's the main point? For Ulysses, the honorable response to time and mortality. يعني الإنسان دائما عنده هاي فكرة الخلود. شون أنا أعيش هاي الحياة وأنا أدري إنه أكون موت بالنهاية. زين شون؟ How should we face the passage of time and mortality? According to Ulysses, is not to calmly accept old age and death, but rather to resist them, to wring every last drop of knowledge and adventure out of life, every possible chance you have to live your life to the fullest, to know something, to experience something, to learn something. You should go. You should go ahead. Don't say I'm old now. There is no such thing as old. You should defy old age and death by this. Okay? Even if doing so may result in dying sooner. ايش تريد راح تموت؟ ايش راح يصير يعني؟ شنو المشكلة؟ المهم انت عشت الحياة إلى أقصى حد. It is the quest for new experiences and new knowledge that for Ulysses defines a meaningful life. مو هو هذا اللي أصلا يعطي معنى للحياة. وأنت أصلا تقعد والله كبرت بالعمر فاني خلص بعد انتهى الموضوع. See, the poem written around the time Tennyson's dear friend Arthur Hallam died is also about having the courage to face life despite weariness and despair. Notice here, some say that actually Tennyson wrote this poem mainly about himself. يعني كأنما هو Ulysses. يعني هو هنا بعض يقولون انه هو يقصد شخصية Ulysses نفسه، هو الشاعر Tennyson. ليش؟ يعني after the death of his friend he actually started to have this experience of maybe he started to feel depressed. يعني شايفين إنسان يفقد عزيز، يعني هو قد يكون حس بعد موت صديقه العزيز إنه هو غرق في اليأس. فهذا الكلام وهاي الأفكار هي محاولة منه ينتشل نفسه من هذا اليأس. To face life, to face these sad experiences in life, this sad encounter with death. شوف الإنسان من يواجه الموت، والموت هنا القصد بيه مو إنه هو يواجه الموت مثلاً يتعرض للموت، لا، من يشوف موت أحبائه، من يشوف موت أعزاء ناس أعزاء على قلبه، هذا يخلق عنده شو نوع من الأسئلة عن الحياة وجدوى الحياة ومعنى الحياة، ممكن يخليه يغرق في بؤس واكتئاب مثلاً كآبة. So what shall he do in order to face life in this case? Okay, Tennyson himself wrote of the poem. يعني هو Tennyson أصلا يعني قايل كلام عن هاي القصيدة. It was written under the sense of loss and all that had gone by, but still life must be fought out to the end. يعني كان يحاول ينطي نفسه دفعة من خلينا نقول الأمل بالحياة. That despite all the kind of despair maybe he has felt, meaninglessness, يعني هذا انعدام المعنى اللي مرات الإنسان يمر به بعد تجربة فقدان شخص عزيز، هو حاول إنه شنو من خلال شخصية Ulysses, through the character of Ulysses, to show that even if these things happen, even if you get old, even if you lose things in life, you shouldn't what surrender. ما تستسلم، لازم تستمر بالحياة حتى آخر نفس. This is all about this beautiful, a very beautiful poem. I hope you have enjoyed and understood, and hope to see you in other videos. Thank you.